Right now, we have the drop-down menu filter in the gallery, but it's not possible to uncheck, unselect a value in the drop-down. And I want to do that. Also, I want, if there is nothing selected, to show all the items in the gallery. Okay, in order to do that, first thing we need to do is to change one property here that's called allow empty selections. This is the property of the drop-down. So let's click the drop down and then change the value from false to true. Okay? So now it will allow empty selections and we can unselect a value in the drop down. It's just taking some time for it to recognize, but now it's done. Okay? I can play the app and then I can now unselect it. See, once I unselect, it's empty. And now is when I want to show all the items in the gallery because there's nothing selected. In order to do this, we need to play with the filter formula that we added in the gallery in the previous video. Okay, if I go to the gallery, we see that it's filtering by the department, but there is nothing telling the filter formula that I want to show everything in case there is nothing selected. How can I do that? Well, we can put another condition here together with this one. So I want to show the context where the department matches the department selected, or I want to show everything if it's blank. And the way to do this is putting an OR condition. So the OR condition we can do by typing OR, or we can put two pipes like this. This also represents OR. Okay, I'll type for a matter of clarity. Let me do even in the next line. So I'll put OR, and then I'll check if the dropdown is blank. There is a function to do that, and the function is the isBlank. Okay, so I open the function, open the parentheses, and then I need to put the expression. What's the expression that I'm going to put? Is the DRP department.selected. It will check if there's something selected. So I'm going to copy this and paste in here and close the parentheses. What happens here is it will test for this condition now. This is the whole condition. So when we have an OR, this comes from knowing logic of expressions. It's something you can practice, conditional logic. When there is an OR, it will return true if any of those conditions is OR. So it will check if the department matches. In case it doesn't match because it's empty, it will check this one and it will check if it's blank, if the selection is blank. This will return true, as we can see here in the bottom, because right now it's blank, so it returns true. Once this is true, the whole condition will become true. And since it's true, it will bring the line. Remember that this logical test will be applied to each line in the table. So it will basically apply true to each line of the table, meaning that, okay, I'm going to display these results. In case this is false, that means something is selected, so this will be false. What it will do, it's checking for the first condition, because the second is already false. So the first condition is department equals selected department. And in this case, it will return true only for the ones that match the selected department in the dropdown. We will have true for this one and false for all the others, and this will bring only the department that matches. I hope that's clear. It's difficult sometimes for the beginners, but as time passes, you get very used with this pattern, checking the value or checking the blank in an OR condition. Okay, let me play the app and see what happens now. It's blank, so the second condition, the isBlank, is true. It's returning all the lines. Once I select, for example, marketing, the is blank is false, and it will check for the first condition that will check if the department of the table is the same as the selected department in the dropdown. It will bring only for those lines that this condition is true. And then we see that we have the two contacts here. I can keep changing the departments and seeing the filter working. And I can unselect and see that everything is showing now. The next step is to combine the search and the filter together so both work at the same time. See you in the next class. This video is part of an entire playlist where I teach Power Apps from scratch. It's also hosted on Udemy as a course, if you want to watch without advertisements. I will leave both comments here in the first comment, in the pinned comments. Also, if this is being useful, like, subscribe, and activate the notifications so you will receive a notification when a new video is released. If you want to continue learning Power Apps now, I will suggest a video right here. See you in the next video.